Hello everyone. So let us discuss about the first chapter of history and civics, the first war of independence, 1857 or Sepoy Mutiny. So before I start the chapter, let it be clear that this chapter can be divided into three parts. That is why it is known as the first war of independence, then the causes and the consequences. Let's come to the first point, that is why it is known as the first war of independence. Though we all know that we got our independence from British rule in 1947, but this 1857 revolt is known as the first war of independence. To know this fact, we have to go back 100 years back, that 1757, after the Battle of Plassey, British entered into the politics of our country. And gradually they tried to capture one after another territory with several policies. British adopted several policies by which all sectors of the society, the millions of peasants, artisans, soldiers, everyone got annoyed. So this is the first time all of them came together and revolted against the British. So that's why it is known as the First War of Independence. Now this, though Indians lost the battle, British won, but British understood that their time period in India or their rule in India might be short-lived. So in other words, we can say that it shook the British government to its very foundation. So now come to the second point, that are the causes of the First War of Independence. First, we will discuss about the political causes. So political causes, remember that political causes can be divided of four parts. First is the policy of expansion. Now this policy of expansion, also British adopted four policies through which they started expanding their territory in India. First of all, outright wars. British fought several battles with India and they captured one after another from east, west, south, north. Every parts of India was captured by the British. First, the Battle of Boxer, 1764, Bengal, Bihar and Odisha, that means the eastern territory, was captured by the British. Then second one is Anglo-Mysore Wars, which duration is 1767 to 1799, and very powerful Mysore state was captured by the British with this battle. Then the third one is Anglo-Maratha Wars, 1817 to 18, and Maratha territory was captured by the British. And the fourth one is Anglo-Sikh Wars in 1849, by which the Punjab was captured by the British. So by outright wars, British adopted the policy of expansion. Then the second one is subsidiary alliance. Now, subsidiary alliance refers to that any Indian territory who wanted to accept British as the supreme power by their own. British gave certain conditions for that, and many Indian rulers accepted subsidiary alliance. It was started by Lord Wellesley. For this, if any Indian territory accepted British as the supreme power, they had to surrender the foreign relations. They can't keep any relations with the foreign countries, any other countries. Second one, they had to agree to enter, not to enter into any alliance. They can't enter into any alliance with any other parts of the country or any other foreign country. Then they had to accept a British resident. That means the British, in their territory, British will keep their own resident. And they also, simultaneously, they had to agree to maintain British troops. In other words, so we can say that British virtually lost their, Indians virtually lost their independence. So subsidiary alliance brought a great disaster to many a kingdoms. Then third one is the doctrine of lapse. Lord Dalhousie made this policy that if any Indian ruler died without a male heir, his kingdom would lapse, that is, it would come under the company's territory in India. And through this policy, doctrine of lapse, सातारा, जयपुर, संबलपुर, उदयपुर, नागपुर, झांसी एंड मेनी अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट किंगडम्स वेयर कैप्चर्ड बाय द ब्रिटिश, केम अंडर द ब्रिटिश रूल. देन लास्ट वन इज ऑफ द पॉलिसी ऑफ एक्सपेंशन इज ऑन द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ एलेज्ड मिसरूल. So, on the pretext of alleged misrule, means Lord Dalhousie again told that, he declared that many a kingdoms were misgoverned and British rule was needed to ensure proper administration. And under this clue, they captured Awadh. And as a result, Awadh also joined.